how do we come to be human? What is being human? In my scientific lifetime, we've moved from seeing almost nothing to seeing almost, you know, everything about individual genomes. And I feel incredibly lucky, actually, to be involved in that phase of discovery. The 1000 Genomes Project is a consortium of scientific researchers around the world who've got together to use DNA sequencing to examine human genetic variation and to find places where our genomes are different. If you take any two people, our DNA sequences are very long, there's 3 billion bases, and they're almost the same as each other. But about one every 1000 places, there's a difference. That means there are about 3 million differences between each pair of people. The people who have been selected to form a sample for the 1000 Genomes Project are anonymous individuals, and we selected them to be fully representative of their population. Initially, we set up a pilot phase. In that pilot phase, we showed that we could do this, and we also found a lot of genetic variation. We doubled, essentially, the amount of common genetic variation that was known. We found over 15 million variants. We're scaling up now into sort of production phases of the project, and in fact, we're looking by next year to do 2,000 people. An important aspect of this project is that it's not just obtaining information that we're going to use. It's we're creating a publicly available resource that anybody can use. It's going to be of most value to human geneticists, and they're already using it. There are publications, there are other scientists who are using the data that we've produced already in the pilot phase to make new discoveries, to study human evolution.
Information from the project has confirmed some of the things that we knew about human evolution. For example, that we originated in Africa pretty recently and have expanded out of there. But it also gave us some new insights as well. It told us that natural selection has influenced virtually every part of our genome. As well as that, we've now got a catalogue of some thousands of genes that we think have been specifically and positively selected in our fairly recent history.
What we're working towards is a catalogue, is a sort of encyclopedia in which you can look things up. So it's really a sort of fundamental framework or foundation for genetic research. There have been a lot of challenges in making the project work and in getting as far as we have. There have been many innovations, both in the technology, machinery of getting the DNA sequence, but also in the processing of the data and how we analyze and interpret genetic data. And all of that is getting published and discussed so that it can be used by other people in future projects.
What motivates me, and probably most scientists, is curiosity. To know what our genome sequences look like, and for someone who's been interested in evolution, then for quite a while now our dream has been to have whole genome sequences to use as a starting point. Now we've got that.